So observe here, what we can do here. So 6 here, so can you explain me, so which is going to multiply, so like which is going to divide in a which step here?
6 sides are 48, sir.
So but okay, so it's become 0, right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, so like something we are doing wrong, I guess.
Sir, in expression mali ok sir cheppara sir, C plus equals to A into B.
Yes. Kada basic man raskuna expression A into B raskunam kavati, first we need to check with this particular expression which is going to take high priority. So whatever we are trying to define as a inside the brace. So later C plus, initially what is the C value? Sorry, we are having 3 here. So we are having 3, the C value. So we did not add the 3 value. It will become 51. So the value same. So forget, actually we forget this particular C value. So the C we are having initially 3 value, after expression completion we are going to get 48. And 48 plus 3, so it will become 51. The remainder we are going to get 3. Okay, so any questions, anyone having any doubts regarding this particular 3 expressions here?
No sir.
Okay,
yes,
sir. So good, so we'll try to check with one more example here using this particular increment and decrement operator here. So basically what exactly this particular increment will do, and if I'm going to add here the simple example here, A++. So this is the, so carefully observe here, post increment. So this is the post increment here, and we are having ++ here. So this is the pre-increment. So these are the very important sections we are going to discuss, because whenever you are trying to attend any interview, so they may ask this kind of example. Most of the time operator related example you are going to get, but some of the calculations we may get the output wrong here. Getting the point? So we need to understand very carefully whenever we are trying to discuss this particular operators here. Observe here, so this we already identified here, this is the post increment operator and this is the pre increment operator. Cutting the point, what is the difference between this particular pre increment as well as the particular post increment here? So what exactly, if you observe, basically I'm trying to define here A++. Cutting the point, so what happens whenever the line number 17 is executed, after executing this particular line number 17, the A value is going to increase by 1. Getting the point? The A value is going to increase by 1. Same way the expression, it will become like this. So how we are identified in the above, so it will look like same A+1. Getting the point? So only the difference here, every time which is going to incremented by 1 here. And if I am trying to add here ++ here, this expression also will be same here, this expression also will be same, A = A+1. But the difference here, whenever we are trying to work with ++ A, like this is we are calling as a pre increment here, what will happen here? Before executing, like whenever we are trying to execute the line number 18, what happens here? First the value is going to increment. The first the value is going to increment here. So simple example here, line the A value we are having here 6. Getting the point? So the A value we are having 6 here, right? Whenever this particular A value we are having 6, so the compiler is trying to execute the line number 18, what happened here? First the A value is going to increase here, the A value will become 7, after increment the a value is going to execute here. The simple one I'm going to define here, plus plus a. So we'll observe the two differences here. So we'll observe one more difference here, a plus plus. So carefully observe here, I'm trying to print the two statements here, the line number 18 and 19. So we need to understand here. So we are getting cases same. Why we are getting the both println statements are printing same value? Because we already identified here the a value initially we are having 6. Based on this particular expression, the a value is increased to up to 6 here. Right. Whenever we are trying to work on the pre-increment operator, what happened here? If we observe here, this particular expression, the value increased first. The value is increased. Initially, the value we are having 6. Now it is increases to 7. Whatever the values we increase, the increased value, which is printed by the println method. Getting the point. But back to here, the line number 19 here. So what we are doing here?
It's not incremented. So first,
yes. First, what happens here? The values will print. Later, the value will increment here. Later, the value will increment. If we observe carefully, if I'm going to print the line number 20, again a value, you can observe carefully. So you can observe carefully the three statements here. So try to understand here what happening here. Getting the point. The line number 19, first two, the value, whatever the value which is resides in the particular variable called a, the value is going to print it. After printing this particular a value, the value is increased here. Getting the point. So when the values increase, whenever the cursor is come out of this particular line number 19, the value increased here. So the value, incremented value, the println statement is not going to print because it will try to come out of the particular println method. Getting the point. So after the line number 20, we are trying to print here the incremented value we are able to see. Getting the point. So this is very important here. So when the pre-increment is going to work, when the post-increment is going to work, we need to understand carefully. Getting the point. Okay. So to understand more, so simple example I'm going to add here. Simple example I want to add here. So I need an answer from the each and every person so we can move another example. Some of the people, if they may not understand here, I will try to explain one more time here. Okay. So the simple example here, increment and decrement here. The name of the example here, increment and decrement here. Okay. So carefully observe the increment and decrement example here. Int a is equals to 1 and int b is equals to 2. And I'm not initializing the c value. And as well as I'm not going to initialize the d value. Right. The c, now I'm trying to initialize here. So carefully observe here. So the d I'm trying to initialize here. Getting the point. So carefully observe. So how the values are affecting here. Later, if I'm going to print here, a value and b, c and d. So we're having around 4 variables here. Okay. So try to explain me what is the output of this particular 4 statements here. So try to increment the values and decrement the values. So based on this particular increment and decrement, we are going to get an output here. So now I need an answer from the each and every person. What happened? So you are not understanding? So you are in bit like you are in the middle of this example. Okay. And okay. So I received one answer. Okay, someone asking to explain one more time. Okay. So what about the remains? Okay. Okay. Only three. So I need more. So that I can explain, like basically the why I'm asking here, what exactly, like what you are trying to think so that I will have a understand here. So you are like you are expecting wrong or right, we'll get in a more clarification here. If you are trying to provide the message also, it is fine. But the output, what you are trying to think, that is important here. Okay. Observe carefully what we are going to do. So basically, so as we explain here, whenever we are trying to work on these particular, so only the difference we need to understand. So this particular expression is a pre-increment or post-increment. We are having already we discussed in the last example. So we are having four increment operators here. We are having four increment. So first one is, so this is the pre-increment. Getting the point. Same way we are having, this is the post increment, right? So this is the pre increment and post increment. Along with this, we are going to have some other example. So those example here, minus minus A, cutting the point, and A minus minus. So this is the post pre decrement here. Cutting the point. So this is, so carefully observe, we are having four increment and decrement operator, two increment operators, two decrement operators. Inside these two, first one is a pre increment and second one is a post increment. Okay, so we'll try to discuss with the pre increment here. What happens here? So for example, now we are in the line number 12. So for example, now we are in the line number 12. So we are trying to work on the pre-increment operator. So what it will do? The pre-increment operator will increment the value first. Later, the remaining operations are going to perform here. Getting the point? The pre-increment operator is going to take high priority first executing here. So executing is nothing but incrementing the value. Whatever the value is incremented, the change, the incremented value is going to assign into the another variable. Or so if you are trying to do any other operation, the incremented value, with the incremented value only we are going to work, right? So the post increment here, the post increment here, what it will do, first it will do some other operation, later the value is going to increment here. Getting the point? So the post increment is going to take less priority because first is doing the other operations, later it will try to update the particular value of the variable here, wherever we are trying to use. Getting the point? The pre is going to take high priority. First it will increment the value, with the incremented value, so it is going to perform other operations here. Same way, the pre decrement here. So what it will do, this particular pre decrement here, it will try to decrement the value first. It's nothing but it will going to decrease the value by one. Every time the value is going to increase by one, and every time the value is going to decrease by one only. Cutting the point. So the pre decrement here, it will try to decrease the one value. Later, with a decreased value, they are going to perform other operations here. Cutting the point. And same way, the post decrement operator. The post decrement operator, what it will do? First, it will do the operations. Whatever we are having the original value, with the original value, it's going to do some other operation. After the operation, one value is going to decrement here. In this particular post decrement operator. Getting the point? So this is the way we need to work with pre-increment and post-increment and pre-decrement and post-decrement. Okay. The simple example here, so we need to understand this particular B. So we are working on the pre-increment operator. The B value we are having as a 2, that will become 3. So the 3 value we are assigning into C. So as of now, the C value 3. And later you can check with the D value. So what is the D value we are having? Something called, whatever the A value we are having, A. The A value we are going to assign into this particular D. Getting the point. So D is equals to 1 and C is equals to 3. Getting the point. So later this particular A value will become 2. Later the A value will become 2. Because what operator we are working here? So this is very important here. The post increment operator we are working here. So actually, so what is the original value we are having? The original value is assigned into the particular variable called D. What is the original value we are having? That is called 1. The 1 value which is assigned into this particular D, later the A value is incremented. Now the A value will become 2. So coming to the line number 7. So we are doing the C post increment operator. Getting the point. We are doing C. The C++ is nothing but the C variable. We are working on the post to increment operator. But as of now, what is the C value? We are having 3. We are having 3. So now, whenever we are trying to execute the line number 12, the 3 will become 4. The 3 will become 4 here. So what are the values we are having? A value will become 2. And whatever the B value, the B value will become how much? 3. Because we are working on the pre-increment operator. So the B value will become 3. And whatever this particular C value?
Yeah.
The C value will become.
We declare as a plus plus now, sir.
Okay. Can you explain me line number?
Print out statement lower as a towards 18, 14, 15, sir. We
okay.
are declaring A value. That is a only plus A. Double plus A kada, sir.
Is it double plus or plus? Basically okay. We are trying to appending here. The string with the into data.
Okay.
So finally, what is the D value? The D value will 1. So what exactly the values we are having here? 2, 3, 4, 1. So if I am going to run the same example, so we are getting the same expected output or not? So you can see 2, 3, 4, 1. So try to understand the same example one more time here. So I will try to remove here. So this is very important example here. If you understand, you can easily work on any example related to this particular pre-increment or post-increment. Okay. Here, by default, we are having A value 1, B value 2. So now, we did not define the value for C and D. Because the C and D values, we are going to get from the A and B. So you can check your line number 9. So we are going to work on the pre-increment operator. The pre-increment operator, what it will do? First, it will increment the value. First, it will increment the value. So what is the variable we are working here? Something called B. So now, the B value will become how much? It will become 3. Because the pre-increment is going to increment the value. So now you can observe the B value become 3. Whatever the value which is incremented, the incremented value will assign into the particular variable. So as of now, the C will become 3. As of now, the C will become 3. So what about the D here? D we are working on the post increment operator. The D we are working on the post increment operator. So what exactly the post increment operator will do? So first, whatever the original value we are having, the original value will assign into the variable, which variable we are working here, something called T. Now you can observe that d is equals to, what is the original value we are having? Something called 1.
Only one.
Right. So later, whenever we are moving into line number 11, the a value will become 2. Because we are working on the post increment. After performing operation, the a value will increment here. So the what operation we are doing here? We are trying to initializing whatever the a value we are having, the value into the this particular d variable. Okay. So after this, the a value become 2 and the d value will become 1. Right. And after this, again, the line number 11, we are trying to check with C++. So it's nothing but, which is, again, we are working on the post increment operator. Again, we are working on the post increment operator. So whenever we are trying to work on the this particular post increment operator, what we can do? Already we identified here the post increment operators. So whatever the original value we are having, so with the original value, so they are going to do some operation here. After completion of this particular operation, they are going to increment the value. So as of now, we are not doing any operations here. Simply, we are trying to increment the value. So when this particular value is going to increment here, so whenever the compiler is trying to execute the line number 12, so at the time of executing the line number 12, the C value will be increased here. Getting the point? So now you can imagine we are in the line number 12. The C value will become how much? It will become 4. Getting the point? So this is the way the values are going to increase here. So anyone having still question here regarding this particular increment?
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, okay, go ahead.
11th line, sir, C++, in which element we are assigning, sir?
No, we are not assigning here. So that is I'm explaining here. Basically, we are not doing any assignment over here. So simply we are incrementing the value. So whatever the C value we are having, we are going to add with another plus 1.
Okay.
With plus 1, we are going to add. So if you observe, what can I do? Like I will try to run the same example in a debug mode so that you are going to have an understanding little bit more clear. So you need to check here. So as of now, a value 1, b value 2. So now if I'm going to click on the next line here, you can observe here. So you can see the b value increased to 3. Same way, the c value also is increased to 3. Getting the point? Because of what operation we are doing here, something called pre-increment here. So whenever we are working on the pre-increment here, what happens here? So first the value will increase, and increase the value is going to assign into the c variable here. So if you observe carefully the d here, so d very important here. Now you can check here, the d value will become 1. Now you can observe the a value will become 2 here. So why it is increased here? Because of we are working on the post increment operator. Getting the point? We are working on the post increment operator. So now whenever I'm trying to come out of the particular line number 11, so you can see the c value also is going to increase here. Carefully observe here, the c value increased to 4. The c value is increased to 4. So this is the way the values are going to increase here. Okay, now simply we are printing the value here. So 2341. And I want to add one more example related to this particular example. Here, I'm trying to remove this particular section here. Okay, as of now, we identified here. So we are having a value 1. So otherwise, I will check with the 20 and I will connect with the 12. Okay. So what I'm doing here, C is equals to minus minus a, cutting the point. And d is equals to plus plus b, cutting the point. Again, a is equals to d minus minus, cutting the point. And later, what I am doing here? Finally, the b is equals to b is equals to something here, c plus plus. Okay, so if I am going to add here the c into d, what are the values we are going to get here? So try to check here the expressions here and provide me the proper output here. So what are the values we are going to get for the a, b, c, d? So we are doing more than one operation here, so you need to understand little bit carefully. So what exactly the values we are going to get here?
A value will not increase, sir. We are not increasing, we are not decreasing, sir. So a value will be 20 only.
Try to read, see one more time. So we already added some location, the a value. Okay, if you know anyone this particular outputs, can you message me like what you are trying to think this particular outputs here? Okay.
Sir, a value 13, sir.
A value 13.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What it would be? Okay. What happened others? Like you are in bit confusion. Like you are trying to think what is the output we are going to get. So whatever it is, whether it is wrong or right, that is a different matter. So can you explain your outputs here?
B value is 19, sir.
Okay. Okay, so observe carefully. So try to do yourself. Meanwhile, I will try to add the a and b values here on the screen so that some of the people they may understand so clearly. So initially a value will become 20, and so the b value we are having 12. So these are the two variables we initialized here, and so we are trying to check with the c value. What are the c value we are going to get? Same way, what is the d value we are going to get here? Okay, so right, same way, can you provide the d values also? So someone provided c value. Okay, d is that. Okay, good. And now observe here. Okay, now we need to check with the line number 9. So what we are doing here, basically which operator we are working here? So it is a decrement operator, right? The decrement operator here, so which type of decrement operator, whether it is a pre decrement or post decrement operator, we need to identify. First, it is a pre decrement operator. So pre decrement operator is nothing but what happened, the a value will become 19. So first the a value will become 19 because we are working on the pre decrement operator. So the same value what we are doing here, we are assigning into this particular c here. we are assigning into this particular tree. So later, back to here, line number 10. So what we are doing the line number 10? Again, we need to check here whether it is a increment or decrement. We need to identify. So here it is a increment. So inside this particular increment, again we need to check. So it is a pre-increment or post-increment. It is a pre-increment. So once it is a pre-increment, what we can do? So the value will become 13. Getting the point? The value will become the same value which we are going to assign into this particular variable called D. Getting the point? So now we can observe A value 19, B value 13, C value 19, and D value 19 we are getting. Right. So later, the line number 11, so what we are doing here? The line number 11, what we are doing here? So this is important here. So what is the D value we are having? What is the D value we are having? So that is called 13. Getting the point? Here, we are working on the post decrement operator. We are working on the post decrement operator. Now, the value will become 13 and the D value will become how much? 12. So when this particular 12 will come, whenever we are trying to execute the line number 12, whenever we are trying to execute the line number 12, the value is going to decrease here. It is nothing but the D value will become 12. Okay. And we have one more statement here. So what we are doing here, B is equals to C++. Again, here we are working on the post increment operator. Getting the one? Here we are working on the post increment operator. So whenever we are working on the post increment operator, what happens internally? So whatever the value, the original value C having, the value is going to add it into this particular B variable. So that will become how much? 19. Because the C value we are having 19 here. Right. So later the C value will increase here. So what is the C value will increase? Up to 20. Up to 20. Getting the point. So these are the expected output here. So 13, 19, 20 and 12 here. So if the some of the people are, they provided wrong or right, can you please recheck your outputs here? So and if it is wrong or right, just correct it. Right. Now we'll try to save the example here. I'm going to run the same example here. Okay, let me clear the screen here. Observe here, 13, 19, 20, 12 here. Cutting the point. So some of the people, they provide as a some different value. Okay, 13, 19, 20, 13, 19, 13. Okay, okay, something, 1, 2, they provide as a wrongly, but to correct it. And I want to provide one more example here. So I'm expecting from all the people because I'm getting only 1, 2 here. So at this time, so I need all the people here. Okay, carefully observe here what I want to do. I want to remove this. So again, the B and A value also, I want to remove here. A value here. Okay, if I observe here, the A value, I want to provide something called okay, 2. The 2 is fine. And the B I want to give as a 45 here. And so C also I'm giving here. The C value I'm giving as a 32. So D also I'm giving here. The D value I'm trying to give 14 here. So these are the 4 variables I'm giving here. Okay. Now what I'm trying to do here, I want to check with A value. The A value I want to check with minus minus. The A value minus minus B. So now you can observe here, A is equals to minus minus B, right? So later I want to check with B. B is equals to what I'm having is something called, so D plus plus, getting the point. So I'm trying to check with the D value as a B value as a D plus plus, and I want to check with the C value. So C value I want to work with this particular minus minus D, and later I want to check with the D value, so that will become plus plus B. And now what I'm doing here, so in between I want to increase the A value, so here I want to increase the C value, getting the point. So later, so I want to check with the final A value minus minus B plus D plus plus. And if I'm going to add for all the sysouts here, so can you please explain me what are the outputs we are going to get? So try to think a little bit carefully and note it down if you're not convenient, like if you're into this some confusion, so that you will get a clear what exactly how these particular values are changing internally.
Sir, I got the A value 44.
One second. Let me complete this out here. Okay. Now A value 44.
I see.
Okay.
B value 14, sir.
Okay.
C value 13.
Okay.
D value 46, but A value is a 59, sir. Sorry.
A value 59.
I see.
Okay.
D value will be 46.
46. Okay. So can you please provide me the output of others? So what you're trying to think, so that we'll have the same example. We'll try to get more clarification here, so that we are giving wrong or right. So that is a different matter here. So please try to communicate with me, so that we can move forwardly and with the new concept. And wherever we are into some drawback, we'll try to cover up the more example here. Okay. Meanwhile, what I will do, I will try to define the A variable, so all the variable section here. And initially we are having A value 2, and so B value 45 we are having, and C value so 32 we are having, and finally the D value we are having 14. So we need to check with this particular increment operators and decrement here. So what exactly the A value, because we are working on the pre-decrement operator. So pre-decrement operator is nothing but B value is going to decrease one value, so that is will become 44, and the A value, how much we are going to get, something called 44, cutting the point. So as of now, A value 44. So later what we are doing here, we are trying to check with B value with D plus plus. So what is the D we are having, right? The D we are having as a 14 here. The 14 we are going to assign into this particular B, and later the D will become 15, because we are going to work on the post increment operator, right? So later,
sir,
what we are doing
D++, so it's not increment, na sir?
Yes, whenever I'm into the line number 12, so definitely the values is going to increase. Getting the point? Initially the D value we are having 14, the D value, the same value we are assigning into B, So now the B value will become 14. So whenever the cursor is trying to move to the line number 12, the D value is going to increase to 15 here. So because we are working on the post increment operator, right? So later the A value also is going to increase here. So how much the value is going to increase here? 1. So that is called, again it will become 45. Again it will become 45. So now we are in the section called line number 13. The line number 13, what we are doing here? So we are trying to decrement the D value. The decremented value we are assigning into C. So what is the decremented value we are having? Initially the D we are having 15. So again now it will become 14. And the 14 we are going to assign into this particular C. The 14 we are going to assign into this particular C. Getting the point? So this is very important here. Now the C will become 14. Okay. After this, what we are doing here? The line number 14, again we are adding C++. Getting the point? The C++ is a post increment operator. C++ is a post increment operator. But basically, when we are moving into the particular line number 15, the C value will increase here. Now observe, the C value will become 15. The C value will become 15. Now finally, what we are doing? The line number 15, we are trying to increase the B value. Here we are working on the pre-increment operator. So what is the B value we are having? The B value we are having as a 14. Now it will become 15. The 15 value we are assigning into this particular D here. So that, so D and B, right now we are having same values. Right now we are having same values here. Getting the point? So now, so this is important here. Initially, what we are doing here? B minus minus. So minus minus B, not a B minus minus, minus minus B. So it's nothing but the value is going to decrease here. So again, so it will, the B value will become 14. And whatever the D value we are having, so the D value we are having 15. So how much we are going to get here? So the A 20. Value 28 or 29. 14 plus 15, something called, we are going to get as a 29. So now the A value will become 29 and the D value will become 16.
Yes,
getting the point? 16 because of the post operator. Because of this particular post increment operator, the D value will become 16. So what are the outputs we are having? 29, 14, 15, 16. Okay. So let me run the same example here so that we'll have a more understanding here. So you can see 29, 14, 15 and 16 here. So these are the values we are going to get. Anyone having a question here?
No, sir.
So all are clear? Do I need to explain one more time?
No, sir, clear.
Okay. So this is very important example. Basically, we need to check first whether we are working on the like pre-increment or post-increment and pre-decrement or post-decrement here. So if you understand the difference between pre and post, so we can easily run any example here. So this kind of example, we can easily run. Okay. So I'm going to clear this particular screen and we'll try to move one more example here. So can you please answer this final example here? So, and so let me define one more variable here, something called A is equals to So simple example we are going to discuss, something called phi. And we'll check with B. B is equals to 7. And later, int C is equals to, I want to check with these kind of operations here, something called B plus plus minus B plus plus minus and minus minus J. So now C value I'm trying to do with more than one increment and decrement, and later I'm working on this particular D. So here what I'm doing here, plus plus C, and again I'm trying to add the same plus here. So internally I'm going to add one more brace here. This particular brace will having B minus minus and plus 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 here. Plus plus here. So these are the enough here. So can you please explain me what exactly the values we are going to get? So if I'm going to print this particular A, B and C and D. So try to work on a little bit attention and provide me the output here, what exactly you are trying to think.
A5.
Okay.
B7.
One second. So A5 and
seven.
B7.
C3.
C3.
D17.
Okay. So we'll observe the same values we are going to get or not. And one more person, 5747. So here another one is expecting 4 also. So 5747. Okay, we'll observe. So what is the correct output here? So 57417 is a correct output here. Okay, somewhere so you did not add this particular one value here, so that you need to check here. So what about the remainings here? Because only 2 persons added, so everything, all the people are clear regarding this simple increment time to decrement example here. Okay, so if you are clear, so what we will do, so we are going to discuss in tomorrow some of the relational, like boolean related operations here. So basically, if the boolean A value true, so what is the output we are going to get? So something called AND conditions or condition we are going to discuss. So tomorrow we are going to have simple small table we are going to define. Based on the particular table, we are going to work on the remaining example here. So those also we are going to discuss the logical, boolean logical operations we are going to discuss. So as of now, like we are going to discuss more 1 week. These are the very basic example. But these are the very basic example, very much interested whenever you're trying to attend any interviews. So online tests or something. So these are the very important concepts they are going to ask here. Right. So we need to understand a little bit more attention here. And whenever you're having any questions, let me know. So I will try to add one more time. Right. So if we don't have any question, we'll try to conclude the today class. We'll continue tomorrow. Okay, so I did not receive anything, so that all the people are clear regarding whatever we discuss in the today class. So if we don't have, we'll continue tomorrow.